where it comes up with wall.
Saugerties girls lacrosse. Introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Chris Kernan. I'm the Saugerties head lacrosse coach. I'm also the athletic director here at Saugerties. I've been coaching girls lacrosse for about 8 years now, where I started as a JV coach at Kingston High School, and then I was the head coach at Pine Bush High School, the varsity head coach, and now I'm the varsity head coach here at Saugerties High School.
One of your better players, Moorea Spoljaric. How is she in the classroom?
Moorea Spoljaric is excellent in the classroom. I looked at her GPA this morning and she has a 90% GPA. So in the classroom, she's definitely getting it done.
How about Moorea as a leader, off and on the field?
On the field, Moorea as a leader, as soon as she touches that field, you can feel that the girls pull behind her and, you know, look for her to help the team out. Moorea is somebody that has the speed and the agility and the quickness, and she's a game changer. And the girls around that, girls on the team feel that. Off the field, you know, going through the halls and stuff like that, you know, people look up to her. She's somebody that, you know, people aspire to be. You have those JV girls, you know, in our program that look at her and really want to be her and see her as the next level.
And does she push the team, like in practice? I know as the year goes on, does she not let people accept just okay?
Absolutely. Her intensity that she brings to practice, you know, and to games is one that people really look forward to, because she's the one, if, you know, our team's having a sluggish day, she kind of gets them pumped up and gets them ready to play. And, you know, she does a great job motivating the girls as well.
Doing the off season to better herself?
Right now we're holding open gyms. That means that, you know, girls can come and they can toss around the ball, you know, to each other, and she's there on a constant basis. We also do the weight room, and during the winter season we have a MAC open gym, which is every Monday night. There's about 4 schools that go to the MAC gym, and it's just a skills session working with, you know, stick skills, right hand, left hand, speed, agility, quickness. So she's getting it done on the off season as well.
Does Moorea have the skills and speed to play at the next level?
I definitely believe she has the skills and ability to play at the next level. I've seen numerous D1 and D2 players, and I do believe she possesses those skills. She has a strong right hand, and her left hand is just as strong. Her speed and quickness helps her on the field, and without a doubt, I do believe she can play at the next level.
Your experience coaching, going to the regionals and all that, you've seen D1, D2, and D3 players. Where does Moorea fit in that bunch?
I definitely believe she can play at D1 and D2 schools, without a doubt. If, you know, she doesn't get recruited and she goes to be a walk-on, whatever she does, she's determined to do things. So if she wants to be a D1 or D2 player, she puts her heart into it and she'll get it done on the field for you. I definitely believe she has the skill and the ability to be a D1 player.
You've known Moorea for some time now. Do you think she's capable of picking up the style of play and the speed in college that makes you challenge yourself?
Absolutely. I've had Moorea on my team for the past 3 years. She's been a captain for the past 2 years. Without a doubt, she can definitely pick up the style of play and the quickness of the game. And we all know the college level is a lot different than the high school level, but I am a firm believer that she's going to be able to get it done. Her ability to get things done on the field, you know, are incredible. And I've seen D1 and D2 players. You know, we all know that the high school game is a little bit slower than the college game, but I'm telling you right now, she has no problem picking up the level of play.
Now, as coaches prep, you've played in some big games like the regional game. Is Moorea that one player other coaches look at and scared because she's so dynamic of a player?
Absolutely. Moorea plays center for us now. And as she goes through the offense and the defensive part, teams look to double team her to try to make her cough up the ball. She splits defenders. She goes to the goal hard. Defensively, you know, she's a threat. And players and coaches, you know, are aware of that, and they do try to double team her and try to take her out of the game. She's very intense, so, you know, they try to get her out of the game, but it doesn't work.
After her splitting the defenders and just being such a dynamic player, what do the coaches from the other team have to say to you about her?
The coaches say that she's a really talented player, and, you know, they say, you know, we hate to look forward to seeing her again, which, you know, this will be my last year with her, so... you know, she's going to be a big miss in our program. You know, we're going to miss her very much.
You know, being at the college level, you can't be a wimp, or you got to have some kind of physicality about yourself. How physical is Moorea when playing the game of lacrosse?
Moorea was, you know, and probably still is, a hockey player. And so she is very physical on the field. She's not to the physical point where she's getting carded all the time, but she is very physical. She knows how to, you know, play the sport, and she knows her, you know, what she has to do in order to get things done. So the physical part is not a problem. It's not an issue at all. It's very funny that you asked that question, because she is a hockey player, so she, you know, she is physical on the field.
With the uncertainty of being recruited, you know, at a small school in Saugerties, would you be surprised if Moorea was a walk-on, or if she went to some premier lacrosse school?
I would not be surprised at all. I'm telling you honestly that when, you know, you meet this girl and you find out the determination that she has, she won't let anything stand in her way. If this is what she really wants to pursue and she wants to be a D1 player, she will do anything and everything to get the job done. And, you know, my team and me, I'm personally going to miss her. You know, the atmosphere that she has created on the team, you know, is one of unity and bonding together, and she pushes the other girls. So, you know, she is going to be missed in our program greatly.
Head coach Chris Kernan, thank you for the interview.
Thank you, guys.